study from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we are going to take a look at another really nice budget knife offering. I have done a couple of weeks or months ago a overview of the Sanrenmu knives, so some smaller really nice budget offerings from a Chinese company called Sanrenmu, and I showed you a couple of models of them that I had in my collection. And I really had to say that the quality and the craftsmanship that you see there in these Sanrenmu knives is quite nice for the money that you're paying. But some people ask me if there is another option if you are looking at some larger knives, because most of these Sanrenmu knives are in a quite small overall form factor, like this one here. So you can see it is a quite small overall EEC blade. And if you are looking for a larger blade, Sanrenmu does not have a lot of option right there. So some viewers also suggested that I would take a look and review some Ganzo knives for a nicer, larger sized budget option, and that is what I'm going to do now. I actually was quite familiar with Ganzo knives even before I started the channel, and this was one of the first Ganzo knives that I got when I started collecting. This is the Ganzo 704, which is a design homage to an HK Benchmade collaboration. I don't know the exact name or model, but it's very, very similar to that model. You get G10 handles, and the blade is marked 440C. You have a bead blast blade here, and it is quite an ergonomic overall design. You also have a very Benchmade resembling clip right here, the split arrow clip from Benchmade, and you also have your axis lock clone right here. Overall, a pretty nice, substantial knife. But the older Ganzos were a little bit on the heavy side for me personally, because this knife that has about a 3.5-inch blade weighs over 5 ounces. I think it's 5.15 ounces or about 150 grams. So really on the heavier side for a knife like this. And that is because they have used some very substantial stainless steel liners, and they also have not drilled them out. So after a couple of Ganzos that I have tried out in the beginning, I steered away from them because they were a little bit on the heavy side for me personally. So this is a representation of the older Ganzos that I was familiar with. But after that Sanrenmu video, I checked out the newer Ganzos that they have to offer, which are marketed under the Firebird name. Hence, you can also see the packaging here in the back on the table. And these knives are quite different from the older Ganzos that I was familiar with. You get this new box that you see right here, and you also are getting a nice little microfiber baggie that is very reminiscent of a Benchmade bag or something like that. So really nice touch there, but also the knives themselves are very, very different from the original Ganzos that I had in my collection for quite some time. But now they have come out with some very interesting new models, like this one here, which is the model number F739, and you can see here it is branded Made by Ganzo, but the main branding is Firebird. And you can see here a really good looking design, nice stone wash on the blade, not like the bead blast you have seen on the older Ganzo right here. Good thumb studs as well, nice jimping, not too aggressive, and also you have the very attractive G10 carbon fiber laminate here on this knife, which is really nice, especially at the price points that these knives go for. And if you peek here on the inside, you can also see the drilled out liners, and also that the liners are actually quite a bit slimmer than on the Ganzo right here, that is an older one. You can see you have thinner liners, and they're also drilled out, and that makes a big difference in the overall weight of this knife, because here you have a weight of 5.15 ounces. And this one here is around 124 grams, so I would think around 4.5 ounces or something like this. So there's certainly a big difference in weight right here by drilling out these liners. And it's also very ergonomic in hand. I was really pleasantly surprised with that. And you can also see that there is certainly a design resemblance to a Benchmade Griptilian, a large one. You also have a blade length here of about 3.5 inches, a little bit more, and you also have your access lock as you had on the older Ganzos. But I have to say the access locks have gotten smoother over time, so these newer Firebird Ganzos have a nicer operating access lock than the older ones, in my opinion. Other than that, it is a really nicely constructed knife. You can see here the tolerances are quite nice. You have jimping in the liners as well, flow through construction, and quite a nice action as well, and also really solidly made. You have no side to side play, no up and down, and this one is certainly much larger than a regular Sanrenmu knife, so a nice full-sized knife for EDC if you prefer that. And you also have a quite generic pocket clip right here that also works quite nicely. So this is the F739 from Ganzo and Firebird, and I'm really a big fan of these carbon fiber handled Ganzos. They certainly look quite a bit nicer than their standard models in my opinion, and they also have quite a good overall quality. Just a good option, especially for the price that they're asking for these knives. The carbon fiber laminate versions of these two knives are running you around the $25, maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less, but certainly very, very affordable knives. And with the features, the steel and the handle material that you're getting here, certainly well worth that money. Really ergonomic design, just an awesome little inexpensive EDC blade. You also have a different pocket clip than on the other Ganzo that I've showed you before. And then now let's take a look at this one here, which is probably the most attractive Ganzo that I've seen so far, with its blue heat colored steel hardware here, carbon fiber G10 laminate, and then the coated blade. This one is a little bit resemblant to the Protec TR4, which is an assisted Protec. But also there are some differences there, of course. Have a nice G10 backspacer here in the back. Same style of clip, but coated. All the hardware is nicely colored in that blue color. Same G10 carbon fiber laminate, the same 440C steel. We're going to talk about the steel later a little bit. And the model number here is the F753. So really good looking knife, very nice in hand here. Just a really good looking and certainly nice to carry EDC blade, and also quite lightweight, because you can see here you also have some drilled out and thinner liners. Maybe I can show you that here, the difference in the liner thickness between the new Firebird models and this older Ganzo that I have here. So quite a bit thinner liners, and as well they are skeletonized, so this knife is going to weigh quite a bit less as well as this one. In comparison to the older Ganzo. So really impressed with how Ganzo has improved itself and also added some new features to their knives. As well here, the axis lock is nice and smooth to play with. One thing that I noticed is that if you get a Ganzo with the coated blade like this one here, at first the axis lock is a little bit grittier than with your stonewash blade, and they also have a really nice stonewash. Maybe I can show that right here. Very, very good looking stonewash that they have on their blades now. But if you get the coated version, it actually is a little bit grittier in the beginning, because the axis lock runs on the tang of the blade that is also coated and is slowly removing the paint, and that adds a little bit of grittiness to the action. But you can see after a bit of time, the coating wears away, and then you have the same smooth action as on a stonewash blade. So that is just something to keep in mind. But overall, I have to say these Ganzo knives, especially the one with the carbon fiber, because I think that adds quite a bit of style to these knives, are certainly a great way to go if you're searching for a budget knife that is still solidly built, has a good steel, and also does not break the bank. So talking about the steel that they use here, you have seen that all of the Ganzos are marked with 440C. But I'm not quite sure if they actually use genuine 440C. I would suggest that they maybe use the Chinese equivalent of that steel, which would be 9CR18MOV. And both of them, 440C as well as 9CR18MOV, are very good budget steels and certainly outperform the 8CR13MOV that you are used to see in these more budget-oriented type of blades. So certainly a nice little upgrade from that standard steel. It has very good edge retention and abrasion resistance, as well as corrosion resistance. So a good upgrade from the 8CR for sure. And in my experience that I mostly had with my older Ganzos, and a little bit also with these two here, It really is a nice EDC. Still, you can sharpen it easily and it will stay sharp for quite a long time, certainly longer than your regular 8CR13 MOV blade that you may be used to. So a nice steel, especially for the price range. If you take a look at the sharpness of these knives, I now had them for nearly a month and used them around the house and also carried them sometimes and used it for standard EDC uses, and they were very, very sharp out of the box. And let's see how well you see that they are using held up over that use. And you can see, really well done. Of course, here at the heel of the blade, there is a little bit of flaring, but not too bad. And you also have a nice sharpening chisel right here on this model. And if you take a look at the other model here, the really, really good looking one with the blue hardware. Let's take a look at, and that is really, really nicely sharp here. Very, very impressive. Very, very good slicer. You also don't have an overly thick blade and a nice flat grind that runs nearly the whole height of the blade, and that makes this knife a very, very good slicer. And I'm actually quite a fan of the steel that they use here for the price points of these knives. So really well done here on the sharpening as well as on the steel choice. And the overall package you are getting here from Ganzo with the carbon fiber G10 laminate, the 9CR18 MOV or 440C steel right here, and the overall craftsmanship, the axis lock that is executed quite nicely. No play, just solid, solid knives in a good size here on these folders. I cannot say anything that is objectively wrong with these knives. Of course, if you have a big problem with the design cues that they take from some other companies like ProTech or Benchmade or some other companies, that certainly could steer you away from these Ganzo knives. But as a knife itself, I have to say those are certainly good EDC users for quite a low price. If I haven't said it before, these two knives run you around $25. And if you're searching for just a nice inexpensive EDC blade, I would tell you to check them out, and you will certainly not be disappointed in these knives. So this was my review of these new Firebird carbon fiber G10 laminate models of Ganzo. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.